Thank you. Very good afternoon to everyone here. Hope you're already having a great summit. We're here, as Mr. Trivedi just announced, for the launch of the India D2C yearbook. I would like to also welcome in Mr. Amitabh Taneja, the Managing Director of Images Group. My proud privilege to be sharing the screen here with all of you here.
Thank you, Naveen. Thank you. And thank you for being with us in this.
Excellent. Excellent. Yeah. So, it's been an immensely, invigorating exercise working through and trying to profile some brilliant, D2C first brands. I'd like to take the next 8 to 10 minutes to walk through the process and just highlight some of the pieces out there of, how the initiative came into being and how the India D2C Yearbook has actually featured. Some very promising names from the industry that can all be good references for all of us here. So basically, the penetration of the internet is now, as we all know, into deeper pockets in India. It's no longer a tier one, tier two phenomenon only. It's been, what's been especially exciting is the fact that there have been a variety of categories that have now made a real play and staking a real claim with a wave of digital first brands in categories like food, beauty, personal care, home, and other such categories. So this yearbook is a step towards unearthing such success stories by profiling about 100 of these prominent and emerging brands. Through our interactions with them, it's been absolutely exciting to see their razor sharp focus in fairly quick time in some very interesting areas, like deep tech, like fulfillment, like, the understanding of the digital space and all the innovation around it, while having a keen eye on EBITDA and even revenue, obviously. It was also refreshing to notice that a lot of these brilliant startups in the near past are actually bootstrap brands, which also speaks great volumes of the potential here. So, back to the presentation now. The estimated size of the India D2C market, I think, we all know of this magic figure of $100 billion. And that growing within the next 4 years itself, doubling up to $200 billion. A huge wave on surge in the number of Indian online shoppers and nearly, going up to 1,000 brands right now, which are D2C brands. Through the study, the D2C ecosystem, here are a quick snapshot of the brands that have gotten profiled. I'm sure you'd love to see, I've got my hands on a first copy here, So thanks, Amitabh, there. So I thought I was the first. I think I'm the second. So
you are the first. I'm the second.
great. So it really has been absolutely exhilarating to see some of the brands, and learn about their journeys. What we've done in this is actually broken it down into about 7 or 8 segments. Food, beauty and personal care, home and homeware, apparel, footwear, accessories, consumer durables, and beverages. So here you can see a quick snapshot of them. But I'll just walk you through very quickly in 4 to 5 minutes, probably just 30, 40 seconds per category, and just so that you get a sense of what we're talking about and referring to here. In terms of food, the Indian food and beverage packaging market was valued at $33 billion, which is USD, in 2020, and is expected to reach $156 billion in just the next 4 years. So brands like Licious, which is now a unicorn as per yesterday's press release, Biryani by Kilo, Tender Cuts, they've all been featured in here, and they call for some exciting reading there. The next category featured is, again, a very interesting and emerging one, beauty and personal care. The Indian beauty and personal care market is, just a moment, I think I lost the presentation there. is expected to be a $4 billion enterprise by 2025. The kind of brands featured in here are Let's Shave, Wow Skin Science, P-Safe. I'm reading directly from the book itself because it's as fresh from here. The next category of focus is home and homeware. This market is worth already over 38,000 crores, for which the size of the digital market itself is supposed to touch $4 billion by 2025. In fact, it is a highly invested category as well, which has secured nearly $500 million in funding just in the recent times. Brands like Wakefit, Sleepyhead, Elementary, Flow Mattresses are all part of the feature coverage within the home and homeware section. Next, the fourth out of the 8 or 9 profile is the much loved age-old apparel category. Brands like Bewakoof, Fab LA, Fable Street, Libas have all been featured in this. It's projected to grow by 84% to over $110 billion in the next 2 to 3 years. And this too, fashion brands, D2C ones, have raised over $750 million just in the last few years. So very exciting times for apparel, fast fashion, and all such categories. The next one, accessories. This too, especially in the last year and a half in the pandemic era, has seen a very interesting uptake in accessories. The market value was approximately INR 280 billion before the pandemic. And it's pegged to, in just the next couple of years, to 850 INR billion in terms of the growth. So accessories, another fairly exciting market there. Just the last two that I'll talk about, and then conclude and have Amitabh just take over the last note there. Consumer durables, again, we always knew that the electronics market, the consumer durables market, was one in terms of huge revenue potential. Brands like Boat, Deezo have all become great success stories that have also been featured by our study along with images. That one. And last but not the least, we've got beverages, another extremely exciting category that has featured the likes of Rage Coffee, Vadam Teas, etc. In fact, the beverage industry is a great contributor to the economy, generating USD 6.5 billion annually to the coffers. It's been absolutely exciting to look at the plethora of categories and what's going on here. Clearly, from a consumer standpoint, convenience, habit, and variety has been the three key hinges, especially in the last 18 months or so. Given the quality of consistent research reports that the Images Group has dished out for many years now, for us at Green Honchos, it seemed a great fit to partner with them in this initiative. Green Honchos has been pioneering the D2C enablement space for a while now, with deep partnerships in the ecosystem to deliver a seamlessly integrated offering for brands to partner and scale in their online business. So thanks a ton for allowing us to participate in this journey. Over to you, Amitabh.
Thank you, Naveen. Thank you so much. Thank you for supporting this report, and thank you for being part of this Internet Commerce Summit. I just want to thank all of you and for being with us today and joining us on this special occasion of launching the first ever D2C report in India. Just a few words about D2C. India is a country of talent, a lot of consumption, the next biggest consumer market of the world in retail. For the last 30 years, we've been part of the retail journey, and I've always said this: retail is a business of creating consumer products out of passion and what you love building. Internet provides that part of the business so easily and accessible to the consumers through online. And that's where you see this evolution of D2C. basically single brand retailers or a category retailers which should have gone brick and mortar need not go brick and mortar now, because brick and mortar is an expensive route and a different route. But D2C is the outcome of the Indian consumption story, which is growing and growing at a pace which is unbelievable. And I think we will see an amazing growth in the D2C category going forward in the next 5-10 years. Thank you so much, everybody. And thanks for being with us. Thank you, Naveen.